A lot of your professors specifically ask you to use only articles that are peer-reviewed, but rarely do they tell you what this means or how to figure out if an article is peer-reviewed. Well, wonder no more, as we're going to take a few minutes to describe what this means and how you can find it. Many, but not all, scholarly journals are peer-reviewed. That means that before an article is published in a journal, it is reviewed by other experts in that field. They make suggestions, look for bias and errors in the science, and then the author makes the needed changes. These peer editors are almost always volunteers who are scientists, practitioners, and/or professors full-time. The ultimate goal of peer review is to make sure that only the best of the best research is published. I have put an asterisk by the last two points, and I'll explain why in a couple of slides. This is what the peer review process looks like for one publisher. Kind of scary, right? It can be a long process from the time the researcher submits their original article to the time it's actually published in a journal. It can take anywhere from 3 months to over a year to get published, if it gets published at all. Again, most of the people in this process have other full-time jobs, so reading and reviewing article drafts is not their first priority. Even though peer review is held up as sort of a magical cure to sloppy science and poor writing, it does have problems. It's important that you know that even when an article does make it through the peer review process, that doesn't automatically mean it's free of error or bias. These headlines are related to peer review scandals in just the last few years. There is so much pressure for scientists and researchers to publish and produce results that many resort to cheating, lying, and falsifying data in order to get published. Some of this stuff does get caught, but more and more bad articles are making their way through. Even so, we will still use it as a tool to help us find a higher level of research. We just need to look at these articles with a critical eye and not automatically accept the findings. A lot of journals are peer-reviewed, but it can be hard to figure out when just reading an individual article. One tool to determine if the journal or the article is peer-reviewed is a database called Ulrix. This database only has information about journals. Totally boring, unless you need to know if a particular journal is peer-reviewed. Then you just type the name of the journal into the search box and look to see if it's refereed. There's a little referee uniform right there. Refereed's just another word for peer-reviewed. Some databases even allow you to limit your search to just peer-reviewed articles. The Nursing and Allied Health database called CINAHL has a lovely little checkbox. Other databases may have this limiter as well. Just look in their advanced search area or something similar. Of course, you can always look up the journal title on Google. If it is peer-reviewed, it will say so, usually in the section titled About the Journal. And here's just a couple of examples. Peer review should ensure that research is well done, and for the most part, it does. There are definitely issues facing the process, but it is still a valuable way to determine quality. You can figure out if an article is peer reviewed by using the Ulrix database, the limiters on some specific databases, or just by looking the journal up on Google.